Very nice. Very nice. Oh well, we should stop worrying now. One for you, if you want one.
We can just share one.
Do you have a lot?
Yes, of course.
Okay, no, I just my wife.
Anyone else?
Well, look at that. Reminds me of a ski resort. Which one do you want to take?
The town of Kotor. The walls on the, you can see the walls on the map, as well as the most important number on the map, that is number one, and that is the main entrance and exit from here, from the old town of Kotor. So that is the visiting point. So Kotor is from a place in Montenegro, about the same. Named after a spring. Kotor beach, and on the opposite side there is the north gate, sometimes called the river, because there is the river Shkuna. The origin of the stone is from the river side. If you can talk about the main entrance, you can see three flags. In the middle, red one with a double cat eagle, Montenegrin national flag. On the right, flag of UNESCO, because Kotor is under the protection of UNESCO since 1979. And on the left, flag of Kotor, the symbol of this town. Kotor is built like a mint, like a labyrinth. And it's easy to find, even the locals sometimes. So you have your maps for Baker. And one more time, the most important number on the map is 15th century. In the very center, there is the Virgin with Jesus Christ in her hands, Saint Benedict and Saint Trifon, protector of the old town of Kotor, always holding the old town in his hands like this. And you can see here also this house looks like a mailbox. In the Middle Ages, served to citizens of Kotor to prepare the town for pass. So-called Prince Palace, because of the city prince used to be in that palace. It was built in 16th century, and you can see some elements of Baroque and Renaissance style on its openings. If you take a look over there where I'm pointing, in the corner on the left, you can see one palace known as Napoleon Theater. Well, remaining from the period when he controlled this area, and that was the period between 1807 and 1813, and that was the first theater on the Balkans. On this side, right side, you can see two beautiful palaces. The one belongs to Kotor noble's palace. And of course, this is the symbol of this square, this rock. As you can see, still in use, still working. It was
was built in 1602. Behind the tower is the Tower of Safety, and in front of it, at the foot of the tower, you can see this stone here. In place is some kind of a pillar of torture. Today you can see that the one that original one destroyed in communist times.
Is it torture?
So, just to tell you that, as I said before, Montenegro was a part of ex-Yugoslavia from 1945 to 1991. And ex-Yugoslavia was a communist country, and it was governed by the turn of Yugoslavia president Tito. That country consists of six other countries, a part of Montenegro, there were Serbia, Macedonia, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Croatia, and Macedonia, and Slovenia. And that country stayed intact until 1991, when happened that tragic civil war on the territories of ex-Yugoslavia. And you're probably wondering what happened. So just to know, some of the countries wanted to separate the ex-Yugoslavia, particularly Serbia and Croatia. The government in Belgrade, Serbia, didn't want to allow them separate peacefully. And that's how the tragic civil war started. First on the territory of Slovenia, then Croatia, then spread on Bosnia and Kosovo, which was a part of Serbia in that time. Montenegro, our country, as well as Macedonia, were only two countries that separated peacefully. And Montenegro was the last one that stayed in some kind of reunion with Serbia until 2006. So we waited for a so long time, waited patiently in order to separate it from Europe. Because there is a lot of people populated in both countries, so we separated on a referendum that took place in May 21st, 2006. And we actually reestablish our independence because we have a more than 1,000 years long state. So we are not yet members of European Union. Well, we are in that process before we join the European Union. We need to accomplish some regulations, affairs, and restrict the rules of the European Union. But we are already members of NATO, which is very important for us, and we are members of NATO since 2007.
May I ask a question?
Yes, of course.
The president is the
Yes, they are mostly private houses, but people mostly live in the houses outside of the old town of Kotor. Because there is a lot of humidity here in the winter time in within the walls. So that's the reason why only 300 inhabitants live here in the old town of Kotor, while the municipality counts around 18,000. So most of the buildings that you can see around are actually for rent in the summer. Okay. Yes. But they were destroyed in the earthquake of 1979. There were two quite big earthquakes in 1667 and 1979. The last one, the last that I mentioned, was quite strong, 7.3 Richter scale. And some houses were completely destroyed, some fell to the ground. So that's the two circled graves actually were destroyed in the earthquake. Okay, let's proceed.
Torture.
Thank you.
best picture. And if you take a look about the main entrance, you can see that beautiful portal from the 18th century. So it is interesting that the owner of the house, Joseph Bestucci, wanted to exchange the family name Bestucci, translated in English, homeless. Because of that name, he wanted to exchange the family name into Stockage, which means but as the legend says, without any success, because he acquired only the that was a very rich family, and we know that they had a lot of houses not only here in Kotor, but also in some other places around in the Volga. Okay, now please.
Not large.
Yes.
Here. You don't like my camera, do you?
Your ears goes off on me because of the face recognition.
Huh?
Ears turns off on me and it won't work for the face recognition to open it.
It should never turn off.
Okay.
You want to try it?
Yeah.
I don't turn mine off. That's your phone. There you go. Snap away.
In some elementary and secondary school. Secondary is free and compulsory. Elementary for all the children that attend 9 elementary school, all the children between the age of 6 and 14. After elementary school, which is one of the high so it's not like a gymnasium in the United States. No, that's a preference for college and for business. You're also going to be a
very lovely palace. Yes, here on the
our right side. Yeah, Kotor is their territory. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, we are now at the Square of Saint Friday. Saint Protector of Kotor. I would like to point to two palaces. All of you, you can see the building, your two flags on the front facade. On the left, flag of Montenegro, national flag, red one, the double headed eagle in the middle, and the lion in the very center. Did you see the blue? Well, because you
during the course of history, Montenegro was
back here.
And that was the flag that was used when the empire was
lost. But then, instead of a line, in the very center were the new flag.
The other flag that you can see on the right hand side, that is the flag of Kotor.
I don't know. I know where your hip is.
Come on, my hip's
my camera, your Fine. Everything fine?
Thank you.
Good hip, good camera?
I have to program mine so I have to walk all the time.
Sit. Okay. And fall down.
Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, first of all, I would like to tell you something about the Saint Strike and Saint Protester. Who was Saint Trajan? Actually, he lived in the 3rd century AD in Asia Minor. Can you hear me? And in that time, Asia Minor was invaded by the Roman Empire. You know that Romans were polytheists, so they believed in many gods. And because of that, they were in the persecution of the Christian religion. Then was only 14 years old, and he refused to be converted in that Roman polytheistic religion. And because of that, he was tortured to be dead. And after a spirit, he was executed. Later, he became a saint. His holy relics were transferred first to Constantinople to the Istanbul, and then in that time, riches lived in Kotor was under Saracens, and he was a benefactor of financial buildings that the old Christian church that existed here in 809, since the 809 when the relics of Saint Trajan came to Kotor. Over there, behind that door, in the silver reliquary chest, along with his hat called Glorious Hat. Now, I would like to explain something about the church, the cathedral, and the two most valuable things in this cathedral are and the other piece behind the scenes. The ciborium is a construction supported with the four red marble pillars, also originating from a local village in Jewish. So, as I said before, many streets and squares, even in Venice, are filled with all kinds of standards and high quality that by the time became a local village. Four red marble pillars originating from a local quarry in Jewish, and construction. On the horizontal beam, you can see the scenes of life and death of Saint Trajan, top blind angel, gilded angel. And that's the work of unknown artists from the 14th century. Behind this tutorial, you can see that silver gilded altarpiece that represent different saints. And in the middle, in the third layer, there is the Saint Trajan. that existed even earlier in the 14th century, and that's the fragment which is in the third layer in the middle that represents Saint Paul. Now if you take a look in the ends as well as on the arches, you can see the remains of frescoes. As you know, frescoes are actually the paintings that depict different scenes of life and death of different saints, but they are painted on a fresh note. So you can see just some fragments of the old castle from the 13th and 14th century, and then the combined of the Eastern, Byzantine style and Western colors. Well, you can see also these silver chandeliers in the church. And in the south apse of the church, there is one altar, beautiful altar, and that was the main one till 1979. Then, because of the reconstruction of the church, because of the earthquake in 1979, was a pretty strong one. It was placed in the south end of the church, and that altar is made in silver, and in the very center there is the gold tabernacle, so to keep in the host, and that's the work of a very famous artist, a very famous Venetian sculptor Venturini Zampa. Later on we'll take a walk and you can take a look at that altar. If you take a look on the side of the church, you can see also four other smaller altars. Over there, there is the altar of Saint Rock. Mm. Then over here, you can see the altar of the Holy Crucifixion. Saint Nicholas is on the opposite side. Over there you can see the altar of the Holy Lady in case you have silver. So protection silver frame serves to protect the icon during the ceremony. And around the altar you can see some silver and gold ornaments. And that are actually the votive gifts. Votive gifts meant by bringing them from all over the world as a sign of gratitude, faith, and help come back home from us. That question is still alive, so the sailors are still bringing the votive gifts, not only to this church, also to some other churches. For example, when the church on the island of the Rock has more than 2,000 silver. Now we will take a walk around to see the altars and
thank you.
drive from in the middle to make an effort.
Good food, good mood, so eat here.
You want your gelato homemade?
No.
To check what? What happened?
Missing somebody from our group. It's easy to follow a different group.
Yeah.
There's so many Viking groups.
But not that one. Like where we live, we say, don't ever say the one with the gray hair, because we all have gray hair. Thank you. That's for you.
Yeah.
You came all the way here to see him. Or her.
Hi, puppy. Hi, can you take a picture?
Oh, those are so cute.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're so cute.
As you can see, we have a dog in Kotor as well.
He can't come on the show.
When it comes to the pets, please take a look over there around the door. You can see one very interesting statue.
The cat
of the
statue.
Cat. Stretching. So, ladies and gentlemen, we are now at the Maritime Square, named after a maritime that once belongs to the family that lived in the town also some very important persons that came to the door from Eastwood, so you can see that monumental variety to balconies on the front. So, I would like to tell you about the maritime spirit and maritime tradition here in Kotor. So, this is the region with a long and beautiful tradition. In this region existed a shipyard even in the 14th century, and also a very famous maritime school that existed in the 16th century. And it was recommended by the Venice Russian Emperor, Peter the Great. And he sent his cadets prepared to learn nautical skills in Boston, that most famous maritime school. So, in that period, in the 17th and 18th century, was the golden age of maritime affairs. So, in that period, people of Balka, so-called Balkans, counted as many as 300 sailors. That fact actually speaks for itself. And in that time, over the small Kotor dominated the while Venice in the same period of 19. So I told you that just to compare the importance of that great center is in that time. But the pull down of the maritime fleet started with the invention of the steamboats and because of the long war with Napoleon. But the people of this region still speaking about the maritime heroes that actually disappeared long time ago. So, Maritime Museum shows not only the developing of the maritime affairs, it's also a cultural level of the maritime. Artist, and
that you will take it, okay? We're going to be on the first floor, and 10 minutes we'll come in down, all right? Make sure to see the line, the Venetian line that I was standing on.
1667, and you can see the drawings of the cathedral. As I said before, these
are destroyed,
and they are not the same size and the same machine today, because there was not enough funds for the reconstruction. And here you can see also one beautiful beautiful round stamp that represents the Battle of Lepanto in 1871. Now it's also as a battle of Christianity against the Ottoman Empire. On the same side over here, you can see the blockade of the town of Kotor by pirate and Ottoman admiral Cairo bin Barbaros. The citizens of Kotor, along with the soldiers of Kotor, as the legend says, supported by Vlastasan of Kotor, reject the attack of the pirate. If you take a look on the opposite side, you can see two bronze panels that represent some distinguished persons, captains and admirals. And on the one on the right side, there is the evil vizier, first some Slav that circumnavigated the world in his brilliant splendid. Now I would like to point to this stone relief that represents Saint Tryphon, again, as you can see, holding the old town of Kotor in his hand. And there is the wing line of Saint Mark with a book. Saint protector of banks. That's probably the work of a very famous Venetian sculptor, Francesco Penso Cabianca. Now, please follow me in this section. I need to tell you that it's not allowed to make a video here. You can take pictures. Photos, but not to recording in the museum. That's not our
no video. Okay. I can't see. I'll go in there. It's your fountain.
Whoa.
Oh, this is it? Hey.
Yeah.
We have no history.
No history.
No history.
Yes, you have, but it's not so long like this one here.
We're like a baby.
It's a short story, it's not a novel.
This is a private sign.
Yes.
Do not read.
Yes.
There are no reading allowed.
Puppy.
Hey. Got a picture of the Church of Saint Luke that was built in 1195 by Mauro Casagrande. In fact, after the construction, it was covered with the frescoes, and some fragments have been preserved until today on the south wall of the church. So typical Montenegrin church, small in size, one nave with a semi-round apse and a round cupola. It is interesting, till the middle of the 17th century, there was a Catholic altar. And then, because till then it was for a majority of the believers, then inside the church was installed the Orthodox altar because of the wars and arrivals of the Orthodox people, mostly from the central part of the country. In such a church, we do two altars are unique in Montenegro, and they are, let's say, some kind of a testimony about the coexistence of two confessions. And believe it or not, the only one that didn't suffer any damages in the earthquakes of 1667 or 1917. So you can see it in original shape.
Hey.
Wow, that's amazing. That's a miracle.
That's a miracle, yes. Okay, now let's proceed this way.
Yeah.
All these smells, it smells wonderful.
Actually, I had more breakfast than I normally do, and I'm just very depressed.
I didn't have her. The Tiffany color.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I feel like... How far can I go?
Oh, right there.
Almost got sweaty.
See, I can't figure out your camera how to get...
Just take pictures. Don't try to get fancy.
I'm trying to zoom in and out and I can't.
Don't. That doesn't do good.
For those who wants to go on the walls, at the very top there is the fortress, also in that street. So straight ahead, and you will see one beautiful decorated gate. After that, there is a 1,300 steps on the top, which means 45 minutes up and 45 minutes down. But we need someone exercise. Just to know, the entrance to the walls cost €8 per person.
Cost €8 to have a heart attack.
So here we're going to finish this tour. I hope you enjoyed the tour. And I would like to wish you a pleasant stay here in the old town of Kotor. Maybe we'll see on another tour today. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Should we follow the shade? Oh.
If I can find my water. I've got water in there.
Yep, take my water out. I'll have some. And then you're... Then you got room.
Yeah, but it was also...
$3 on the table. There's two cars on the table, three spades. One sitting for one car, he's sitting.
You saw Julie.
I just wanted to see if
damn pigeon. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because, there's that torture statue. I'd be thankful if they beheaded me after 3 days of torture. Thank you. That's enough torture. where you're going. My hands are full right now. If you want to hold my water, I'll exchange for the phone. Is your Misty Mountain hot? Yeah. No, you might be able to play with it later.
We can get better.
You can always do it.
I took one, but I think we can get better ones from our room.
Oh. All right. Oh. Yeah, from the comfort of, from our heaven on earth ship.
You were wonderful. Thank you so much. Thank you. You too. She was very good.
Not as loud as I'm used to, but that's, I'm the only one that's deaf. Well, I mean, she just speaks at a normal volume.
She reminds me a lot of Arianna Huffington.
Yeah, yeah. Is Arianna your cousin? Aunt?
No. Well, who knows?
Yeah. It works like that, you know.
What's that underground?
There we go. I like that.
Well, I wonder if that's how you get back to the ship.
It is. That's how we got here. It's that amnesia.
I don't know.
Yeah, I doubt that the larger ships can get in here.
Well, Princess is here.
But they're smaller, like ours.
I don't know.
You don't like that Norwegian?
I didn't size it up. Big enough to have a water slide and stuff. Hey. Blue cave. There's a blue cave. With a little bit of carpet on the side.
You dropped something.
No, that was this. I squished my barcode. I'm going to need